The famous theme song is a tune that was whistled as Andy and Opie walked down to the fishing rink. fact, there was one very famous series with an animal who was the main actor. Mr. Egg was an American television sitcom that premiered in 1961 and would continue to entertain viewers for 5 more years. The show's title character was a talking horse named Mr. Egg, who interacted with his owner, Wilbur. Wilbur was the only human who could hear Egg speak. A running gag involved other characters hearing Wilbur talking to Egg and asking to whom he's talking.
But how could they make a horse talk?
Reports circulated that the talking effect was achieved by crew members applying peanut butter to the horse's mouth. But this wasn't the real story. The producers kept the actual method of making a horse appear to talk a secret because they thought kids would be disappointed if they found out the technical details of how it was done. So they made up the peanut butter story and everyone bought it, of course.
Hello.
Say goodbye.
but with hearts of gold. Speaking of an opera, our next show brought together a collection of characters from different backgrounds that found themselves stranded together for 98 episodes.
Stranded together?
I wouldn't want to be stranded with you two.
Yes. The series, which premiered in 1964, was called Gilligan's Island, and it followed the comic adventures of 70 castaways as they attempted to survive on an island on which they had been shipwrecked. Gilligan was the first mate to escape. The other characters included a movie star, a millionaire and his wife, a professor, and a Kansas farm cop. Show creator Sherwood Schwartz explained that the underlying concept of Gilligan's Island is still the most important idea in the world today. That is, people with extremely different backgrounds being in a situation where they need to learn how to get along and cooperate with each other as a matter of survival.
Just sit right back and hear Tilltale making a trip that started from the stronghold aboard this tiny ship. The mate was a mighty sailing man, the skipper brave and sure. Five passengers set sail that day for a 3-hour tour, a 3-hour tour. We're getting off, the tiny ship was tossed. If not for the courage of the fearless crew, the minnow would be lost. The minnow would be lost. The ship left out on the shore of this uncharted desert isle with Gilligan, the skipper too, the millionaire and his wife, the movie star, the professor and Marianne here on Gilligan's Isle. So this is the tale of our castaways. They're here for a long, long time. They'll have to make the best of things. It's an uphill climb. The first mate and the skipper too will do their very best to make the others comfortable and shop at by the nest. No phone, no lights, no motor car, no single luxury. Like Robinson Crusoe, it's primitive as can be. So join us here each week, my friends, you're sure to get a smile from seven stranded castaways here on Gilligan's Isle.
Greetings, those of the 1970s and 80s from Gilligan's Island trip to the
one of the characters named Rose?
You must mean Golden Girls. Golden Girls started in 1985 and ran for 7 seasons. There's about 4 older women who share a friendship and a home in Miami, Florida. One of those women is the famous Betty White, who played Rose. The song you remember is titled "Thank You for Being a Friend," and it's actually written by Andrew Gold in 1978, 7 years before the show aired.
Thank you.
Oh, I love the 90s.
I know, right? Hello, I am.
Like, the fashion was so cool, so bright and colorful.
Hey, did you know that the first texting happened in the 1990s?
Oh, sorry.
As I was trying to say, I am a spirit of the 90s. And as you were saying, the 90s ushered in a new era for television and for the world. Up until this time, there were only a handful of television networks airing a handful of programs. But by 1990, cable television made its appearance on the scene, and the number of cable services aimed at specific audiences with specialized interests grew at its greatest pace ever. By the end of the
film producer.
Many TV shows of the 90s produced today's celebrity.
The original publications of the vision refer to the 1950s, but the new publications is also to new advances in television technology such as HDTV, online video platforms, TV streaming, and video on demand. Entertainment is not available in 24/7. Our technology has changed. We still watch TV and movies. We still want to see the world for the new generation. This brings us to our next series.
Thank you.
our generation is finding a good way to spend it, like maybe building a rocket or fighting a monkey or climbing up the Eiffel Tower, discovering something that doesn't exist, or giving a monkey a shower, surfing tidal waves, creating nanobots, or locating crazy science brain, finding a dodo bird, painting a continent, or driving our sister insane. This could possibly be the best day ever. And the forecast says that tomorrow will likely be 1,000,006 times better. To make every minute count, jump up, jump in, and seize the day. Let's make sure that in every single possible way, today's gonna be a great day. Crossing the tundra or building a roller coaster, skiing down a mountain of beans, devising a system for remembering everything, our secret nights in submarines, racing chariots, saving tiger sharks, constructing a portal to Mars, building a time machine, stretching a rubber tree, or whittling away on guitars. This could possibly be the best day ever. And the forecast says that tomorrow will likely be 1,000,006 times better. So make every minute count, jump up, jump in, and seize the day. Let's make sure that in every single possible way, today is gonna be a great day. Hey, this is fantastic. This could possibly be the best day ever. And the forecast says that tomorrow will likely be 1,000,006 times better. So make every minute count, jump up, jump in, and seize the day. And let's make sure that in every single possible way, today's gonna be a great day. Today's gonna be a great day. Be the best day ever. Today's gonna be a great day. Could possibly be the best day ever. Today's gonna be a great day.
Thanks, thank you so much. You really had a blast in the past.
Thank you for teaching us the history about television past.
It has been our pleasure. Before you go, we have one last